Hello and welcome everyone. So in the previous video we have created auth controller. In the auth controller we have added the basic features like login and register, user login and user sign up. Now in this video what we are going to do is we are going to create some middleware. That middleware will just validate the token coming in the header, and we can also create some other set of middleware like if you are writing a post, right, no one else should be able to update that post, or if you have written some comment, then no one else should be able to update that comment on a particular blog post. Okay, so we will write some custom middlewares. These middlewares can be placed before our route handlers, like we have created these routes, right? Similarly, we can create other middlewares which can be placed before executing these routes, like we have other is router.patch or update or delete. Like I'm just updating one particular user. Well, let's make it simple. We can make it simple. Put call, and here I'm passing ID. Okay, here I will be passing the middlewares which I wanted to execute. This is an array. Okay, and same as user controller. User controller dot delete user or edit user, right? Similarly, I have another method which is a delete user, so I will be calling the delete method, delete user, and I'm passing the ID same. Okay, now what we will do is these are the protected methods, right? Put and delete, we are deleting the resource, so these should be protected APIs. So what we can do is we can create a middleware. So here in this middleware we can create two different middlewares which we need. Is first is check JWT. This will do nothing but it will validate the token that you are passing the correct token or not. So check JWT token here. We can write a simple function. Check JWT, and it will be, so any middleware has three arguments: request response, not that one. We have response of type response, all are coming from Express, and the next, which is a next function. Oh. I mean, you just need to check on these next function request. Okay, now we have this particular method, and what this method is doing is it will be validating the token, right? So what we will do is we will try to access the headers, request.headers.authorization. If it is having this particular header, that if it is not having this header means we are done here. Request response.json 401, and we will just send JSON and some message if you want to send, or we can use some custom template. Not provided, or you are not authorized because you are not providing auth token. Otherwise, if you are providing token, that will be coming from request.headers, request.headers.authorization. Okay, here we need to split this token into some spaces. Like I will be splitting this because sometimes what happens, we are passing the token as a bearer space token value. This is, we are passing as a string. So we got the token here, request.headers.authorization. Okay, this request is of type this. Why it is complaining? Because we are trying to access this, so we have to say that request will not be undefined, or what we can do is we will just check, we already checked this request.header.authorization exists, then only try to do this, and we are splitting it and we are getting the token, right? Now we got the token, we just need to validate this token is valid. So we will put something in the try catch. next error. Okay, here we'll just we'll get the payload. JWT payload is initially null, and now what we will do is JWT payload will be JWT.verify, and we will be passing the token and the secret key process.env.secret key. Okay, now if we got the token, then what we can do is we can request dot payload equal to JWT payload. So we'll just assign this payload to request.payload, and JWT we can get from JSON web token. Okay, here payload doesn't exist on this, so for now. So we this is a TypeScript warning, right? What is happening is on the request there is no such property type payload. So in this particular case, what we can do is request.payload equal to JWT payload. So we verify this, and from the verification we got the payload, and we are assigning that payload to the request object. If we are getting any error, so what we can just, instead of doing a next, we have to just say response.status 401, and here we can see in the JSON message invalid token provided. Right, it's simple, and we'll just return from here. Yeah. So this problem, this is just a warning. What we can do is we can just define the request. Implicit type is any. Request is of type request. It doesn't have any this particular property, right? So that we will fix all these typing in the next session. So here we can also create another is that so sometimes what happens, we don't want to allow a user to update himself, right? So in this case, what you are going to do, let's create another module, another middleware. Check is user, so what this middleware will be doing is it will be just checking that whatever the user we are getting in the payload. So first that middleware will trigger check JWT, and it will add the user information in the request.payload. Now what we will just do here is in this try catch, in this particular block, first of all we already got the user information in the request payload. So const current user id equal to request dot payload we have, and in the request dot payload we might be having user request dot user id. Now what we can just do is current user id if this is equal to the request parameter we are passing, request.params.id. That means you are trying to update yourself or you are trying to get your own data, right? So if this is the case, then we are just allowing you to next. Otherwise just say response.status401. So that can be a case where we want to, like, you can update your own profile, no one else should be able to do it. You're not allowed for this operation, something like this. Okay, here what we are doing is, here we are accessing just an argument request.params.id. Right, we are just converting it to number, and we are comparing it with the current user ID. So current means logged in user ID. If both are equals, then only we are allowing you to update this particular user profile, right? Because user can update his own profile. No any other user should be allowed to update other user profile, right? So current user logged in should be equal to the passed parameter ID in the request.params, then only allow this, otherwise send this 401. So these are kind of custom middlewares you can write in your application.